and PI Patel Sahib and Bharat Bhai Rajista. Again, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Bye.
We thank you, Kanti Bhai, for his good words and great words towards the Ganpat University. Now in short time, our president of Ganpat University, Shri Anil Bhai T. Patel, will address. Once again, afternoon, everybody. Once again, good afternoon to everybody. With us, we have very important personality, Shri Anil Bhai Patel. We all of us know very well about him. From his vast experience of the field, education field, industry field, and even from the government point of view, his experiences are very important to us. We can learn a lot from his experiences. So I request Honorable Anil Bhai Sir to convey blessings and best wishes to all of us. Shri Anil Bhai Sir, please.
It's indeed a great pleasure for me to be here at the second convocation of the Ganpat University. My dear friend Ganpat Bhai Patel and all others, donors who have initiated this program of imparting education for the empowerment of the young people of Gujarat by providing the facilitation for technological and professional education here is coming up in a very nice manner. Today, more than 1,000 students are getting their degrees in the various fields of profession, engineering, pharmacy, management, computer studies, postgraduate degrees. I congratulate all of the students who are present here or who are not been able to remain present. I wish them a great success in their life after achieving their valuable educational qualification from this university. Friends, it is the endeavor of all concerned, all stakeholders of Ganpat University to continuously strive for upgradation and improvement of this campus. Today, more than 7,000 students are educating themselves on this campus. More than 2,000 students are staying on campus. And this campus has developed in a very nice manner. It's all because of the students who are studying here, the faculty members, the lecturers, the professors, the principals, and all who are concerned and who are devoting themselves for imparting the valuable knowledge service to the young people of Gujarat. All of you know that our country, India, is on the threshold of a development process. With India growing at a 7% to 8% GDP growth rate, Gujarat is growing at more than double digit growth rate. And this provides an ample opportunity for the development of the young people. But the prime requirement is that this young generation should be empowered by the process of knowledge and technical education in the various sector specific learning, so that when the new industries come up in Gujarat, these young boys and girls get the opportunity to be part of these enterprises in Gujarat. Honorable Chief Minister Narendra Bhai Modi, through Vibrant Gujarat summits, have put the whole state on a different footing. In fact, there has been more than $200 billion investment proposals in the pipeline in Gujarat, and next 12th and 13th January, some more investment proposals will be coming up. The Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, DMIC, which is passing through Gujarat with the collaboration of Japanese government, 40% of the stretch is passing through Gujarat. And because of the natural geographic location of Gujarat and the infrastructure and the mindset of the people of Gujarat, who are more enterprising and receptive to the investment, they are receptive to the investors and the business people coming from other states or other countries of the world. The reason is that Gujaratis have made their remarkable position world over, wherever they have settled, and they have assimilated themselves in the business environment all over the world. And this gives them the inspiration to invite the other business people from all over the world to come to Gujarat, and they can come up in such a fine manner. I congratulate once again to all the students who have graduated. I also want all the students who are at present attending classes in this university, and we want to assure them that it will be the continuous endeavor of the management of this university and this campus to continuously strive to upgrade the technical education facilities here. We also want to have the ethical understanding by the students in their life, so that when they go into the business environment, they do not forget the ethics and the moral values in their own life. Because of this only, I think the true spirit of the donation and the donors and the people who are giving their time and intelligent and their knowledge for this campus for the benefit of the students will really bear fruits. I thank you for patient hearing. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. It was really our pleasure to listen to great visionary like Sri Anil Bhai. I once again thank you him for sparing some time on this busy day. It was really very great opportunity to listen to him. Once again, we will listen to him in few minutes from now. As this was the long session of webcasting, almost 3 hours is complete. So we will take a little break now for a few minutes, and we will come back with the live webcasting once again. Thank you for listening. Thank you.